Imagine the entire country is prospering and everything seems right in the world. You feel that you and every American has a bright future ahead. But now imagine that future you thought you had in store, you thought would burn brighter than the sun, doesn't happen. What if the very land that you grew up on, that you made your livelihood on, that your children and family depended on, was ripped from the earth itself and thrown into the sky? What could you do? What would you do? When a single time period can cause millions of Americans to be brought to their knees, would you not consider it important? When a decade kills thousands of men, women, and children, should it not be considered a turning point? Welcome to a ravaged land filled with these harsh realities. This is the Dust Bowl. Leading up to the 1930s, poor farming methods and overplanting were harming the land of the Great Plains, accompanied by an increase in farming the years before the Dust Bowl were catalyzed. Currently, wheat is valued so highly, you are practically growing gold. Maybe you are. Your fields certainly have a beautiful yellow all throughout them. Green is a thing of the past. It is simply you, your family, and your fields of golden heaven. The reason you are growing so much wheat? It is a valuable farm commodity, your most valuable at the time. A state of war left many soldiers needing food. Wheat was their go-to answer. Because it is easy to grow, you have continued, even after the war has ended, to harvest wheat. Many of the native grazing grasses have been removed in order to have more cultivation. There is much machine labor. Many feel this is the easiest and cheapest way to grow the most crops. The previous Dust Bowl took place in the 1860s and involved many of the things the future one would entail. These things included a grasshopper plague, a powerful drought, and blowing wind. In the 1930s, the Dust Bowl was a major event. The actual turning point involved several facets.
Well, it turned my farm into a pile of sand. Yes, it turned my farm into a pile of sand.
It would get so dark. I had to hit that road. In the middle of the day. With a bundle that in my hand. The people in the same room, even with the lights on,
I spent 10 years.
You could tell if somebody was in the room, but if you hadn't have known who it was, you wouldn't have been able to identify them. It was so dark.
Well, it was, you know, we were very poor people. My father worked. He was never out of work, but he was paid such low wages, it was very difficult to get along.
Your already small wheat crop is devoured by grasshoppers and jackrabbits. You try to kill and repel them with poison and jackrabbit drives, but you lose most of your harvest anyway.
Yes, she was a good gal, long, tall, and stout.
Furthermore, your wheat has lost value and your equipment has put you in debt. This contributes to the awful cycle of the Great Depression. No money gets put into the economy, so the depression only gets worse. In turn, it is harder to make a living. Many are forced to live in terrible conditions in slums, tents, and camps. Despair settles over the plains.
I had to pack up and go, and it just blowed in. And I'll soon blow out again.
Most of the time we were as frightened as we would be in a tornado. They were very, very scary. And they would roll in from a certain direction, usually from the northwest. And they would just come rolling, and the closer they got, you knew that it wasn't a rainstorm, but it was another dust storm. And then when the storm would be over, sometimes when we'd take the sheet down and go out, we would have, everything would be colored except our eyes. Everything else, we would have dust all over us.
One storm, Black Sunday, killed so many, there is no accurate death toll. The deaths were caused by people breathing in the silt and sand that was in the air, which could either coat the lungs or cut into them. In order to escape the dust, many people tried to migrate west. California, Oregon, Washington, and Idaho were popular migration destinations. Out of these shifts, grapes and oranges became popular crops grown by migrants, leading to a boom in the wine industry. Those who migrated were called Migs, Gypsies, Okies, and Arkies, and were generally disliked. Because of the hardships the 1930s time period brought, a sense of camaraderie spread across America, especially within the Great Plains. Everybody helped everybody else.
When my mother got all of the canned goods and things that she needed from the garden, we went to the neighbors and told them to come to our garden to get whatever they wanted. And it was a really, really nice thing, because people to this day still tell me how great that was of us to share with our garden produce.
In current times, people wonder, is another Dust Bowl bound to happen? We may very well have another Dust Bowl on our hands. Countries like China are beginning to see regular dust storms, swarms of cicadas and grasshoppers, and rising asthma cases, showing that those who do not learn from history are indeed doomed to repeat it.
It's very possible it could happen again. Farmers are draining the Ogallala Aquifer so quickly that within 20 years it could turn into a real bad situation.
They learned, you know, after the Dust Bowl, and they began to teach the farmers how to do contour plowing and have hedgerows and things to break the wind and not have great expanses of level ground that's going to catch the wind again. So they learned a lot.
But I think the better informed you are, the better chance you can prevent any catastrophes, whatever.
How to explain a place where black dirt fell from the sky, where children died for playing outdoors. How to explain 9 million acres of farmland without a master. FDR. How many more must die before the world learns from the dirty 30s? How long will it take for everyone to adopt some responsibility in preventing this tragedy from happening again? It's up to everybody to look out for the earth and her future. People like FDR, ideas like contour plowing and alphabet agencies, events like the Great Depression and Black Sunday have taught us much, but it's up to us to use the lessons of the 1930s. The 1930s, a time that changed America forever through a crucial turning point. The Dust Bowl, an unforgettable farming catastrophe.
And the wheat fields waving and the dust clouds rolling. The voice was chanting as the fog was lifting. This land was made for you and me.